Sure.
Thank you, Senator McCain. John Broder with the New York Times. Senior Pentagon officials are expressing concern about the rise of the Taliban and Al-Qaeda in Afghanistan and Pakistan. One, do you share that concern? And two, have the United States have the resources to devote to fighting those enemies there, given the surge in Iraq?
Yes and yes. Yes, sir.
Let me
elaborate a bit. A lot of the situation in Afghanistan, as we all know, has been related to the political situation in Pakistan. And we know that we've been very disappointed in the lack of cooperation between Pakistan and Afghanistan, Pakistan and the United States, particularly in the border areas, including in Waziristan that I have visited. And we also worry about the Karzai government and corruption in that government as well. And so we have a lot of work to do, and this is a formidable adversary, and the challenges are great, not only for us, but for our NATO allies, who I'm very happy many countries are engaged with us there. But to somehow think that it's an either-or situation, either Afghanistan or Iraq, is a fundamental misreading of the situation in the Middle East. What happens in Iraq matters in Afghanistan. It matters in Iran. It matters in all the countries in the region. If we had failed in Iraq, if we had pursued the policies vociferously advocated by Senator Obama, we would have risked a wider war. We would have seen a beachhead by Al-Qaeda. We would have seen increased conflict amongst the different factions in Iraq. And we would have then, I believe, faced the probability of a wider war. Instead, what we've done, thanks to the surge, is to see the Iraqi government and military gain ascendancy. We have seen progress in the democratic process in a broad variety of ways. We've seen Maliki emerge as a much stronger leader than many anticipated. But that progress is very fragile, and I'm confident that General Petraeus will portray it as such. So again, the path of setting artificial dates for withdrawal will cause failure. And if we fail in Iraq, I am confident that will encourage our adversaries and enemies in Afghanistan as well. And you hear that from the messages that are transmitted by Al-Qaeda leadership. And so it's not an either-or situation. We need to succeed in Iraq, and I am confident that we can succeed in Afghanistan. But it's not just a matter of more troops. It is a matter of a whole lot of other factors, including those, and not exclusive to the ones that I just outlined. Yes.